Kurt is one of my best friends ever, period. He is one of the humans I have been closest to all time. And today, we get to play him for round one of BBR playoffs. I am both excited and a little nervous, but not as nervous as I should be, really, just because I'm very happy that I get to play one of my good friends and that no matter what, one of us is going to move on to the next round. I'm not even going to plug myself. If you have not already, please check out Kurt in the top right-hand corner right now. He makes some of my personal favorite content for Draft League. He's funny, he's upbeat, and he's one of my favorite people, man. So seriously, show him some love. Tell him I sent you. Make sure to sub if you have not already to Kurt. And fun story, right before we get into this team builder, again, you want to skip this, there should be timestamps down below. Whenever I first started YouTube, started Draft League YouTube at least, Kurt was one of the only people to really super support me. He told me that I have the capability of being the next A Drive, and he's been one of the most supportive friends that I could ask for on this journey. And it's surreal to be able to play him now on the big stage and playoffs and BBR. It's gonna be awesome. I'm really looking forward to it. With that being said, we are not soft. We have to focus up because I want to win this game. Obviously, I want to win BBR, at least make finals, man, because not only will that help grow the community, but it'll help grow my confidence. So without further ado, this team builder is going to be kind of long. Be sure to check out the timestamps. They should be at the bottom of your screen right now. You should see little segments of each Pokemon that we're going to talk about Kurt's team, the outro, things like that. Kurt's team is going to go ahead and be Iron Bundle, Terra Water, and Terra Fire Volcarona, King Gambit, Slowking, Serena, Iron Jugulus, Gardevoir, Palmot, Hippowdon, Lycanroc, Dawn, Day, and Muk. Where do I even begin with Kurt's team? So the first thing that I guess I want to say is that I think this is a matchup where every single Pokemon on my team and on Kurt's team has some usability. At least on my end, every single Pokemon on my team got thought about, got thrown out. I thought about bringing it. I had a set for a couple different ones. Even Sandaconda. Sandaconda was actually the seventh Pokemon. He's unfortunately not coming, but he was the closest to coming that is not coming. As for Kurt, there are obviously a lot of very scary Pokemon, but a lot of Pokemon do better into us than others. For instance, his top three Pokemon should always come. Iron Bundle does really well into us. We don't have a great resist. We have three water types, but all of which do not enjoy taking freeze dry, and Mochian obviously does not enjoy taking an ice beam. So I do highly expect a boots iron bundle, and I expect his moveset to be flip turn, freeze dry, hydro pump, and then either encore or ice beam. Next up, Volcarona. You have no reason not to bring your Terra Pokemon, and Volcarona tears me apart very similarly to Iron Moth. He doesn't really need the Terra. He can Terra Water just for the defensive capabilities, but Terra Fire doesn't really do super well here. So I do expect Terra Water, maybe even no Terra Blast, just because he does like that defensive water Volcarona. As far as a set goes, there are a couple different sets. The set that I think is most likely to come is just Quiverdance 3 attacks, those 3 attacks being Terra Blast, Fire Move, and Giga Drain. But the set that destroys me if he brings it is sub Quiverdance 2 attacks. I think we are going to see some variant of Volcarona. One of those two sets more than likely could also just be 4 attacks with specs. I think that is also an option, but with my reliable hazards and his less than reliable removal, I don't know how much I think that's going to be an option. And then King Gambit. I think King Gambit comes, it's his only dark resist on his team, the only Pokemon that can halfway switch into Chi and Pao. I fully expect a Chapo Berry on this Pokemon. There's no way around it, because otherwise he just gets smashed by Chi and Pao. If he doesn't bring this Pokemon, then we could just lead Chi and Pao and try to claim a KO turn one. As for the other three slots, like I said, I genuinely think any of these Pokemon can come, but the three that I think are the most likely are going to be Slowking, because Slowking just is a very good defensive wall into us, especially for something like Quaquaval, which can get a little out of hand if he does not bring that Slowking. And it can also sit on our Slowbro. Obviously, he's not doing very much back to us, but we can't do very much to him either, and he can just throw off some future sites. And then the last two slots, I think Palmot comes. I think Palmot destroys us. I think we have such a bad Palmot matchup, and that is actually why I debated on bringing Sandaconda, because if he is simply Life Orb Palmot, he gives us a lot of trouble. I'll talk about it a little bit more later, but he can simply be Close Combat, Mach Punch, Thunder Punch, and Ice Punch with the Punching Glove or the Life Orb, and he really rips into the team that we are bringing. And then lastly, I think Hippowdon comes, just because if Hippowdon does not come, Kilowattro goes absolutely insane. As for other Pokemon that I do think could come, I think that he could force Serena. Serena's a little weird though, because he needs it kind of for the spin, but he can also just bring boost on a bunch of Pokemon. I have Glamora, and Glamora beats Serena in general, so I can guarantee outspeed it always, and I can get my hazards up or kill that Pokemon. So it's really weird to bring that Pokemon. If he does, maybe it's Scarf. I have no idea. But with the combination of Glamora plus Chiempao and even Goldingo, I don't necessarily see it coming. But if he does bring it, it makes total sense because Rapid Spin is kind of a necessity into my team when it's his only remover. I think Iron Jugulus also makes a lot of sense, only if he wants to check the Goldingo with that Pokemon, which I think he can kind of do with other Pokemon, such as Aspidef Hippowdon. And with the Chiempao and the Kilowattrel, don't necessarily see the Iron Jugulus coming. Gardevoir is a weird one. I think it could come, but I think there's just Pokemon that do better than it, quite simply. And if there's not, we always have a Goldingo to switch into it, so that will be no problem at all. I mean, it could be a problem. I'm not saying it's going to be a bad bring. I'm just saying I think he's going to go other options. If he does bring it, though, I highly anticipate Scarf. Lycanroc. Lycanroc is a Pokemon that I kind of anticipate him bringing. Simply be four attacks, Acelerox, Stone Edge, Psychic Fangs, and Drill Run, and he hits our entire team for really good damage. And paired with Hippowdon, it is super scary. The only thing, it just doesn't do a whole lot of damage. He would kind of have to be banded for this specific matchup, but if he's banded, he's locked into a move, and a certain Pokemon, whatever move he locks into, will be able to play around it. So I don't think Lycanroc could come, but if it does come, I completely understand it. And then Muk, he could just bring to have a T-Spike Absorber, I don't know. So that's kind of where I'm standing with Kurt's team. I hope that makes a lot of sense. Basically, Iron Bundle, Volcarona, King Gambit guaranteed come. The other three slots are really up in the air. Palma is probably my next best option as to what I think he's going to bring. And then I think Hippowdon Slowking, but again, Serena, Iron Jugulus, Lycanroc, Gardevoir, all of them make sense. But I think we have a pretty good team for what he has. I actually like our matchup. Kurt said he likes his matchup. I actually enjoy our matchup. Let's get into why I like our matchup. No different than any other week, our first Pokemon is going to be Chiempao. Terra Dark this week, because he just simply does not have a Dark Resist besides King Gambit, which we get Sacred Sword for. Crunch plus Sucker Punch hits everything on his team. We have Ice Shard just in case he's a booster energy or potential agility. Iron Jugulus, I believe it gets agility. And then of course we have Sacred Sword to hit the King Gambit. This set's pretty simple. We ended up being boots, and a lot of thought went into this. I almost went black glasses, but ultimately Chiempao doesn't have the best bulk, but it's bulky enough to where we can EV it to live certain hits, which you're going to see right here. Because we don't have the most reliable removal in this matchup, which we'll talk about in just a minute, I felt like boots to make sure that we don't take any unnecessary chip other than sand is going to be pretty important. Black glasses will be nice, but I think we can play to where everything's in range of Chiempao without them. We have 204 attack, 100 defense, 20 special defense, and 184 speed Jolly. So this is a very, very in-depth Chiempao, because I do think Kurt is a very good player and I very much respect him. Our Chiempao can outspeed Kurt, creeping us, creeping him, creeping our Kilowattrel with the Iron Bundle. So if he wants to get aggressive with the creeps on Iron Bundle, we actually potentially outspeed that Pokemon, assuming no booster energy, which I don't think he can afford in this matchup. But otherwise, we just simply outspeed everything on his team, barring Scarf, barring Sandrush, Lycanroc. We have enough bulk to live once we're Terra'd, a banded edge from Lycanroc after sand, so that would be 94%, and a Hydro Pump from Iron Bundle after sand, with the rest in two attack. I would say this is a breaker, but this is more so the win con. You guys see how I play Chiempao throughout the season. It's no secret I like keeping my Chiempao in the back and trying to win with it late game. And that's going to be the game plan here as well. There is going to be a couple of different scenarios where we can get Chiempao in early, try to fire off crunches, get a read on the King Gambit set, get a read on a couple of different sets. But for the most part, this is going to be in the back just doing damage. The only chip that this Pokemon should take is if one, a Scarfer outspeeds us and catches us off guard. Two, if he's Rocky Helmet King Gambit, which if he is, we'll be able to kill in return with Sacred Sword, no problem. And then three, Sand Chip. Other than that, Chiempao just does fantastic in this matchup. Again, the game plan is just to get this Pokemon in a position to click Crunch as much as possible. Our next Pokemon is going to help facilitate that. It is going to be Glamora. As I mentioned before, Kurt's removal is very poor. It is simply Serena, and Serena has a very poor matchup into us. Could I see him bringing it? Yes, but if he does, we can take advantage of that Pokemon with a couple of different options. We are Spikes, Mortal Spin, Sludge Wave, and Earth Power. I debated Spikes and Stealth Rocks back and forth for a long time just in case he is Booster Energy Bundle, but I ultimately decided on Spikes for a couple of different reasons. For one, it helps us chip the King Gambit significantly more than Stealth Rocks, and with that King Gambit switching in consistently on our Chiempao, that is going to be crucial to get it in range of Sacred Sword. Two, Hippowdon is also going to want to switch in on us, assuming we don't have Energy Ball, which obviously we don't. So any chip on that is also going to be nice, especially because Leftovers will mitigate the Stealth Rock damage. And three, Slowking comes in on us guaranteed, usually, typically I would say, And every time that comes in, we can get a spike up and we can stack and we can potentially get three spikes pretty easily in this matchup if he does end up bringing Slowking. We are Mortal Spin and we are Mortal Spin very cautiously because I almost brought Energy Ball in this slot because it would help us pick off a potential weakened Slowking as well as a potential weakened non-Spadef Hippowdon, which I do think he'll be Spadef, but just in case he's not, could help us pick that off. But I opted for Mortal Spin because if King Gambit does want to switch into us, we will have a guaranteed switch into it that we'll talk about a little bit later, but it will be taking consistent chip throughout the game and that will put it closer in range of course, our Chien Pao and one good Earth Power call, and that just kind of neuters the King Gambit in general. Sludge Wave hits pretty much every Pokemon on his team, and the Pokemon that it does not hit, Earth Power hits for at least neutral damage. Earth Power is primarily there for King Gambit. The only Pokemon we can't really hit is going to be Hippowdon, and of course, we're not staying in on Hippowdon anyway. We are Pasho Berry, Pasho to catch the Terra Blast on the Volcarona, as well as a Hydro Pump from the Iron Bundle. We actually can live those guaranteed with the Pasho Berry, of course. And we are Toxic Debris. I opted on Toxic Debris over Corrosion, which was definitely a difficult decision to come to because we could just easily Toxic whatever Pokemon was to come in on us, whether it be Slowking or King Gambit, and put us in a really good spot there. But I did just want to be Toxic Debris just in case he brought Serena. I feel like it's very vital to get the Toxic Spike up as he potentially U-turns or whatever the case may be. We can also switch in on the Palma and we could get some spikes up, some T-spikes up on him, which would be fantastic. And it also helps us if we do not get our spikes up, we can see what is Boots and what is not, specifically the Iron Bundle, because while he could be Booster Energy, I think Specs is also an option in this matchup. And seeing whether he's Booster, Boots, or Specs, that turn immediately as he comes in on T-Spikes is just going to be super clutch. We are 224 HP, 244 Defense, 28 Special Attack Modest, and 12 Spadef. I opted to go no speed because I don't think, even if he brings Serena, I don't think you can afford to outspeed my Glamora. I don't think that's the function of the Pokemon. I think maybe you'd be more of a Spadef AV type of Serena to take hits better from our Goldango, but honestly, I don't know. I didn't think that he would bring it. I don't think there's any reason for me to try to creep that Pokemon, especially when I like our EVs elsewhere. We can live two non-Life Orb close combats from Palma, which is very, very important, because if he is Life Orb, he does do a KO us, but then we have counterplay to him because we can Oko him with a couple of different Pokemon. We can live a Iron Bundle Hydro Pump if he is Specs with the Pasho Berry, and then we went the rest into Special Attack Modest. This Pokemon is going to be an enabler. We can switch it in on Palma, who otherwise destroys us, by the way, because I opted not to bring Sandaconda, which is our only real Palma dancer. So this Pokemon is going to be crucial to find out damage on the Palmon. Our next Pokemon is obviously going to be very important. You guys are not surprised. It's Golden Boy, Goldango, Recover, Light Screen, Make It Rain, and Shadow Ball. I have become such a fan of Goldango throughout this season. Man, I'm so happy I traded for him. And that's going to be no different this week. This week, Goldango has probably the most important role on the entire team. He has to take on Iron Bundle. Surprisingly, he can do that quite well, assuming he is not a Specs Iron Bundle, in which case we have Pokemon that resist water and we can switch into it fairly easily. And if he is Specs, we also have Sucker Punch Chien Pao to beat that Pokemon. For Recover, for longevity, we do want to switch into the Iron Bundle consistently, and staying healthy is going to be the key to doing that. We have Light Screen. Light Screen is fantastic. We are actually Leftovers, not Light Clay, which is a decision I bounced back and forth between, but I ultimately decided longevity is better than Light Clay and 7 turns of Light Screen. But if you look at Kurt's team, Light Screen is going to throw him for a loop. His primary attackers are Iron Bundle, Volcarona, Iron Jugulus, Gardevoir. A lot of these Pokemon, obviously, all of these Pokemon that I named are going to be special. So being able to cut their attack in half, even just for 4 turns, is going to be very, very nice. It's going to alleviate a lot of pressure off of a lot of Pokemon. Going to alleviate pressure off Goldango himself once we get that Light Screen up to take out the Iron Bundle. And of course, Iron Bundle only has 8 Hydro Pumps, which is something we have to keep in mind. And then we have Make It Rain plus Shadow Ball. I wanted to go Thunder Wave just for the Slowking, but because we're bringing Toxic Spice, I opted against it. I wanted to bring Thunder Wave just for the potential Iron Jugulus switch in or for the potential King Gambit switch in, but I opted to go with Shadow Ball because our team kind of struggles with breaking Slowking outside of Chien Pao. So I thought having Shadow Ball to have a Pokemon to guarantee switch into and beat the Slowking is going to be a lot more important than Thunder Waving the King Gambit, who's going to get shipped over time. We're 120 HP, 56 Defense, 88 Special Attack, and 244 Spadef Calm. We can live 2 Gardevoir Modest Shadow Balls, which in turn allows us to live 2 non-boosting Iron Bundle Hydro Pumps. We can live 2 Punching Glove Palmot Thunder Punches, just in case it ever comes to that. And then we went to Rest and Special Attack. Again, this is our pivot into Iron Bundle. Light Screen is going to be crucial. And this is also our pivot into Gardevoir if he does decide to bring it. Next up, you guys have made fun of me because something I say quite often is, does this person have a good electric resist? And if the answer is no, we bring Kilowattro. So we are again bringing Kilowattro. We're going to be Scarf specifically. Kilowattro's role specifically is Iron Bundle. Iron Bundle, I know, gets Ice Shard. Don't think he can fit it in this matchup. Maybe if he doesn't want to bring both Freeze Dry and Ice Beam, but he needs the damage output to be able to break Wu Qian if we do bring it. So we're Scarf to be able to beat that on top of a Booster Energy Iron Jugulus on top of a plus one Quiver Dance Volcarona, because I'm 100% sure he's bringing water. We have U-turn to catch the potential Hippowdon. Thunderbolt plus Hurricane obviously does big damage, and then we're Thunder Wave, because if we can't Oko a plus one Volcarona, we're gonna throw off a Thunder Wave and then it's slow, and then we can be able to pick it off with Chien Pao, with Goldengo, with whatever the case may be. We're able to pick it off with something, and this Pokemon is likely going to be our lead. I'll talk about it a little bit more later, but I'd say about 80% of the time, Kilowattro is going to be our lead. We're 16 HP, 196 defense, 176 special attack, and 120 speed timid. We're super bulky, and this allows us to lift a Life Orb, Lycanroc, Acelerock after rocks. We can outspeed the Jug if he is boosted, and then we went to rest in a special attack. We're pretty bulky Kilowattro, but this Pokemon is here. It's going to be a pivot. Obviously, you guys know what Kilowattro does. If he doesn't bring the Hippowdon, we're going to be able to click Thunderbolt super free into his team. And if he does bring Hippowdon, then obviously he doesn't have a whole lot that wants to switch into Hurricanes, except for King Gambit, which obviously we're going to chip throughout the course of the game. It's going to get chipped. And this is the way we revenge Palmot. So Hurricane does about 80% minimum if he is a non-invested Palmot. So after two rounds of Life Orb, we'll be able to revenge that Pokemon. And that's why it is crucial on Glamora to get the information as to whether he is Life Orb or not. Our next Pokemon is unfortunately a force to bring. We have to bring down Dodo. We have to bring Assault Vest. And we have to be some form of Liquidation, Body Press, two moves. I chose Body Slam and Bulldoze. Body Slam because Kurt doesn't have great resist. And getting a para on a Boots Volcarona is going to be key. Bulldoze because we can make the Volcarona slower if it ever comes down to it, and it's Volcarona last mon, we can just consistently bulldoze as he tries to set up, and eventually we'll win the one-on-one. This Pokemon is here specifically for the Volcarona, but obviously it can pivot that role if Volcarona is one not brought, which I definitely don't see happening, or two, Volcarona dies early on. It can pivot to the Iron Bundle. It can pivot to the Iron Jugulus. It has a lot of different functions. We're 240 HP, 4 attack, 16 defense, and 248 special defense with a careful nature. We're obviously unaware to try to mitigate the Volcarona as well as we can. We can break a max HP Terra Water Volcarona sub with the Body Press. That's why we have 16 in defense. And then we just went simply max special defense, rest in HP. And to be a rock filling number of HP, we went the remaining 4 in attack. There's not a whole lot to talk about with Dozo here. It is simply here just to beat the Volcarona. And then lastly, I don't know why I keep bringing this damn Pokemon. I really don't like it, guys. I promise. We have Quackleball, whose role is actually unbelievably crucial in this game. Like, I'm talking Quackleball could be the difference between us winning and losing this game. We are a bulky Quackleball with Roost, U-turn, Aqua Step, Close Combat. Roost for longevity. This is our King Gambit switch in. King Gambit gets in Headbutt, but if he's offensive invested, he will kill us. He will kill us if he's a Choice Banded variant or damn close to it. But if he is that, he does not beat Chien Pao, so I don't think he's going to bring that. If he does valuable information, we know our Chien Pao can come in, claim a KO at that point. We have U-turn because if we are in on the King Gambit, and I highly expect it to be some sort of defensive variant of King Gambit, we can U-turn free of charge on the incoming Slowking, get Chien Pao in, we claim a kill. Aqua Step. Aqua Step is important because one Aqua Step gets up, we outspeed everything on his team that is not named Iron Bundle, and then Close Combat sends things packing, specifically the Terra Water, Iron Moth, the Iron Bundle, and then we have Rocky Helmet to consistently get more chip on that King Gambit, because that is going to be crucial to get Chien Pao in a position to win the game. We're 16 HP, 112 attack adamant, 160 defense, 92 special defense, and 128 speed. We can live two banded adamant Kowtow cleaves after two layers of rocks. We can live one freeze dry from a non-boosting Iron Bundle after rocks. We can outspeed everything except Bundle and Lycanroc after a plus one. Lycanroc because I don't know if he's going to be max speed. I don't think so. And even then, Sand is probably going to be up, so it's not going to matter regardless. And then we went to rest into attack adamant. Like I said, Quack's role is super, super crucial. We get these U-turns on the Slowking. We get Archie and Pao set up in a position to win the game. Obviously, we have to scout. We have to see what type of scent the Slowking is. If he hits Colbert with a bait Trick Room, a bait Thunder Wave, obviously, it's going to be very crucial. But I think this team can win. We have the Chien Pao win con. We have the Goldengo with Light Screen. We have spikes. We have everything that you could ask for. And I think we've built the best possible team that we could against Kurt. I'm ready to go into battle. I'm ready to win this game, man. So if you guys are excited to see me face Kurt tomorrow, be sure to leave a like. And again, please check Kurt out. I love Kurt to death, man, one of my best friends. But with all that being said, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and fight Kurt. Thank you so much for watching, and I don't intend on our BBR season being over after this game. One thing I didn't explain with Quack and Kilowattro is our lead is kind of dictated on the Pokemon he brings. If he only brings Hippowdon, no Palma, we are leading Quapaw. If he brings Palma, we're likely leading Zapdos. If he brings both, it's going to be a toss-up between the two, but still likely Kilowattro. Again, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to tune into our match tomorrow. Should be the best one of the season. But thank you guys so much for watching. And for now, guys, this has been John Jr. signing off.